In this illustration, we'll analyze about a case when a rod is hinged in water. We are given that a thin uniform rod of length 2L and a specific gravity 0.75 is hinged at one end to a point L by 2 above the water surface with other end immersed in water. We are required to find the rod inclination to horizontal in equilibrium. Here, if we draw the situation, we are given that this is, say, a water level, and above water level there is a hinge H located at a height L by 2. A rod is hinged and the other end is in the water, so finally the rod will be located in such a manner that a part of rod is located outside as it is hinged and another part is submerged in water. Now, in this situation, if we consider that rod length is 2L, which is given to us, and a part length X is there in air, so 2L minus X length of rod will be submerged in the water. In this situation, at the midpoint of water, its weight will be acting, and that is, say, W. And in the submerged length, at the midpoint of the submerged length, it will be experiencing a buoyancy force in upward direction. This we can consider as center of buoyancy and this is the center of gravity of this rod. So, in this case, we can write first the mass of rod. We can write as M is equals to, we can write it the cross-sectional area of rod we consider as A. Its length is 2L and its density we can consider as 0.75 times rho of water as we are given its specific gravity as 0.75. So, this is the mass of this whole rod. If we calculate the buoyancy on rod, then we can write the buoyancy force is given by the weight of liquid displaced by the submerged part of rod, which can be written as A multiplied by 2L minus X multiplied by density of water times G. Now, in this situation, if the rod is in equilibrium, we can write about the hinge, the total torque on this rod must be equal to zero. So, we can write for equilibrium, net torque on rod must be zero. This can be considered zero about any point. So, here we can consider about H also. So, we calculate torque about hinge. Here we can consider the inclination of rod to be equals to alpha. Then here about hinge we can say this torque is given by due to the weight. It is W, which is mg multiplied by the distance from hinge, the perpendicular distance of this weight from hinge. As this L, this can be written as L cos alpha. So, we can write it L cos alpha minus the torque due to the buoyancy force, which is Fb multiplied by this distance about the hinge, can be given as 2L minus of, you can say 2L minus X by 2, because this distance is 2L minus X by 2. This distance also we can write, this 2L minus X divided by 2. So, this helps us in calculating the torque. This is the force of buoyancy multiplied by 2L minus 2L minus X by 2 times of cos alpha, this should be 0. Here, cos alpha gets cancelled out and the relation we are getting is this mg we can substitute from here. So, this will be 1.5. This also we can write 1.5 times al rho w. So, this will be 1.5 times al rho w g multiplied by l. Cos alpha here gets cancelled out. Minus this value, we'll see it is force of buoyancy multiplied by this term, force of buoyancy is a times 2l minus x multiplied by rho wg multiplied by this term is 2l plus x by 2, and this should be equals to 0. And if we simplify these terms here, a rho wg gets cancelled out again. So this is giving us 1.5 l square minus 2l square plus x square by 2 is equals to 0. So this is giving us x square by 2 is equals to l square by 2, which implies the value of x is equals to l. And this implies here from the figure, we can get the value of sine alpha, which is equals to l by 2x, that is equals to 1 by 2. This implies the value of alpha we are getting is 30 degrees, that is the result of this problem. The inclination of rod with the horizontal.